on solution demonstration. So this is, as you understand, overall solution demonstration. So not only purely one feature, but really everything. So we are going to spend quite a lot of time in the configuration aspects. So the agenda for today would be an overall setup, a review of the setup for what is inside the local fabric, because there are a few things that we need to remind you about. The configuration for without roadmap, and then the configuration with roadmap, and then we'll cover all the benefits like EVPN next hop rewrite, the site transit removal aspect that I was mentioning, the route aggregation, route filtering, and path optimization. And then we'll go through troubleshooting. Some troubleshooting, I've got many cases, but we'll see how we move forward. In the demonstration, I'm using 8360. You see the caveats yesterday on 8360. So this is used, border is qualified, but border leader just for proof of concept and such kind of demonstration. I remind you about the topology. So we've got three sites, site one here. So the big one on the bottom, site two and site three. And site one features two fabric. Fabric one, fabric two, site two as fabric three, and site three as fabric four. We have those VTEP and border leaders in site three, site two, and in site one with fabric one border, that is the border leader. The VTEP five, the border of fabric two, is a regular border and does not do any control plane to the other fabric outside of site one. So the topology is there. We've got this underlay, those circuits here that are interconnecting. So on purpose, no direct connectivity between fabric one and fabric four, and using intermediate underlay nodes, as we discussed yesterday. We have a bunch of VMware server to host workloads connected to our top of racks in the infrastructure. So we call that either VMs, hosts, or servers. That would be exactly the same way. The control plane summary, again, from what we saw yesterday. So just to recap, we have in orange here, local to the fabric, the IBGP EVPN control plane that you are familiar with. So that was the single fabric aspect with route reflector function hosted on the spine. So then we have the same on Fabric 2, the same on Fabric 4. We don't have a route reflector here because this is just only two nodes. So I didn't put any route reflector here. And on Fabric 3, this is actually a single node. So there is no IBGP here. We have external BGP session for IPv4 address family for the underlay routing that is to carry the loopback IP addresses for the route of reaching the loopback 0 and loopback 1 for Anycast IP address sourcing the VXLAN tunnels. So that's in the light blue, I would say, over the physical circuit. And then we are constructing EBGP, EVPN, multi-op. Multi-op is a key aspect of that sessions between those border leaders here. So there is a triangle for those three border leaders. And then the session between the border of Fabric 2 and the border leader of Fabric 1. So this the aspect of EBGP multi-op is a key because we are going to talk about when we talk about the transit function removal of the fabric, we'll question ourselves, can we remove that transit capability or not? And is there any pros and cons of having a transit? And we'll see there is no benefit at all having a transit because those EBGP sessions are multi-op. So the underlay, so the reliability relies on the underlay to reroute traffic for BGP sessions over the path that is that might change if there is a circuit failing. So this is the control plane summary. Data plane summary, we saw that yesterday, again, those orange internal fabric tunnels and those blue inter-fabric tunnels. Then the a little bit explanation of the VRF. So we've got mainly two VRF we are going to use, VRF1 and VRF2, several subnets and VLANs inside those VRF. So the subnets are quite easy to remember. 10.1 is for VRF1, 10.2 is for VRF2, and we have .10, .11, .12 for inside for VLAN 10, 11, and 12, and for VLAN 20, 21, and 22 for VRF2, .20.0/24, .21.0/24, and so on. L2 VNI and L3 VNI as well. You see the subnets details here, and we'll get into details of which particular workloads we will use. So here we have VLAN 10 that is stretched and extended between Fabric 2 and so let me put the laser maybe facilitate. So here we have VLAN 10 that is extended between Fabric 2 and Fabric 1, between Fabric 1 and Fabric 4, and between Fabric 4 and Fabric 2, right? VLAN 12 is extended between those two, and VLAN 11 is extended between those two. This is the very much details with the workloads you see here. That so the VM are numbered, VM 15 here inside VLAN 10, so that we'll check the traffic with VM 10 here, which is inside the same VLAN. Another VLAN 10 workload here. And another VLAN 10 workload here as well. So you see that on VRF2, for instance, we do not use L2 VNI. It's purely layer 3 VNI on those oversights as well. We've got some DHCP server as well. I will just refer to what we talked yesterday about DHCP server for Windows, and here we'll briefly see the configuration for DHCP. That particular VMs here, VM12, is actually DHCP client of the server that is in back in the backend infrastructure inside the default VRF, and we'll see how we link that DHCP relay back to the default VRF. You have all the IP address highlighted in the slide for the loopback, which are source IP of the VXLAN tunnel. So that's very important information to for all the troubleshooting we are going to do. With that, I can put the next slide, which is all the IP address of the circuits. You get all the configuration, so you'll see that in the config. So the drawing will help you in following up during your homework exercise how to understand that. Given in the slide deck, you get all the config of the equipment. So here, so if I move to the that edit window, you simply have to click here, and you get the config. Okay, so that's very practical for all of you, just to review that presentation. I know this is quite a lot to digest and absorb. However, I try to make the slide deck as convenient as possible for you to get through that. So all config of all equipments are that is live in the lab are put embedded in the slide. So next is some output command. So here, exactly the same than before. Okay, if I put back the slide, you can simply double click on one particular here, that would be the EVPN route. So you have on all the nodes that I'm referring to those, to that drawing. So typically that's for the Fabric 3 here, Fabric 2 on that guy, Fabric 2 on that border as well, here on the border leader, VTEP 8 as well. You have all those commands. So those commands are the show EVPN routes. The show EVPN routes with the extended community, quite important to understand the route target, how the route target are received, so that if the route is in the scope of the locally defined route target, the EVPN MAC IP address received, the MAC address of the switch that I seen on the switch, the ARP for each VRF, the routing table for each VRF, the VTEP information, the VXLAN information, and the EVI. So you've got all of that by just double clicking on that light blue on for each of those nodes. So quite useful as well, hopefully, for you to browse through that presentation later on if you need. Some work done on the IP address management that would be typically useful for some proof of concept or first deployment for testing. So think about that IPAM needs to be quite strictly defined. I'm not going to spend too much time on that because we can talk a lot about that. But just as an example, you must provide some IP global IP scope. So for uniqueness of IP address among all the fabrics, that's of course. And you may have as well local IP scope for IPs that are just local to a particular site or a particular pod. Right, so you need to think about that. And then there are plenty of variation and on things that you need to consider, like do I have a service VRF in which I include some services? Do I have a transit VLANs for? So I let you read the slide later on. I don't want to spend too much time on that, but think about IP management is not something to underestimate when you deploy that solution. So here, I give you an example of what I have in the lab so that you have, for instance, here, that's for data center one. Here, this is for data center two. Here, this is for data center three. So this is sites. Huh? And then this is across sites, what is defined for my VRF. Right, with the corresponding VLAN, if I have some transit VLAN, which I do have in the config, you will see that as a best practice. We do have some transit VLAN, how to number them and so on.